Shalom, this is Yitzhak Ruvain of the Temple Institute in Jerusalem. I'm here with Rabbi Chaim Richman, the world's foremost expert on the red heifer in the English language. Rabbi, what are we looking at right here?
Yitzhak, we're looking at some exciting new footage that we have just received of a brand new red heifer that was born in the United States of America and is being raised as a red heifer according to the laws of Torah for the purpose of possibly, hopefully, presenting her to the people of Israel for the role of cleansing in the building of the third temple. So this is very, very exciting.
Rabbi, she is a beautiful beast, a very, very beautiful animal. Can I just ask you, what's the significance of the red heifer?
So the red heifer is a very important ordinance. It can be found in the book of Numbers in Parshat Chukat. It actually begins with Numbers chapter 19. And it's about a cow of a very particular color without even two hairs of any other color. And this red heifer is actually the secret of cleansing, the secret of restoring a certain level of purity, which is intrinsically necessary for the building of the Holy Temple and also, for example, for the purification of the vessels that have been created by the Temple Institute for use in the Third Temple. The reason this is so significant and really exciting is because there haven't been that many perfect red heifers throughout history. They may not be that unusual in nature, but for a red heifer to be without any of the blemishes, whether internal or external, the physical blemishes that are so common in the animal kingdom that would disqualify her, but that heifer would have to be isolated and raised from a certain age, a certain way. And the folks who have been blessed with the birth of this heifer, they live somewhere in the United States. We're not going to be more specific for security purposes, but they are very enthusiastic, very great supporters of Israel, and they are feeling very, very blessed that they've given birth in their herds to this heifer, and they are hoping that this could be a candidate for use for the resumption of the process of purification as detailed in Numbers 19. And by the way, the whole concept of the Para Aduma, the red heifer, as detailed in Numbers 19, it's a very complex and deep subject. Our viewers can log on to www.templeinstitute.org and go to the red heifer link in the menu bar to learn more about the background and details of this amazing concept and why it is so imperative, and why, in fact, the God of Israel determined through his wisdom that the ashes of the red heifer is the secret to the restoration of purity in the world.
Rabbi, this red heifer is about 5 months old, I believe?
This heifer is just about 5 months old. She was born back in the month of Shvat, which was January. She is actually an Angus and Galvia mix. Galvia are early, easy birthers with low weight, low birth weight calves. And she's mixed with a red Angus. In fact, her father is a red bull. And
you can see her father in some of this footage. I think he goes by the name of Rusty.
Yes.
Point out that the coat on this red heifer past the shoulder is a little bit lighter. That's because it was molting at the time, losing its winter coat. You can just see now, we just saw its beautiful red hoof, which is apparently also a qualification, not just red fur, but the
yes.
hooves and nose also have to be of a reddish hue.
In Torah, as preserved by the tradition of Jewish law, the red heifer, that redness is consistent. It goes all the way to the hooves, it goes all the way down to the skin, it can be even seen in the eyelids, and it's a consistent color. A lot of people ask, well, this is brown, because they were expecting like a bright, screaming fire engine red, but actually our sages determine para aduma, the word aduma, red, is closely related to the word adama, which means earth. And it's basically the hue of the earth, of the clay in certain localities, and a number of hues could be kosher. But what really makes the red heifer special is the consistency of the hue and the fact that there aren't any other hairs of any other color. I'll just point out also that at this time the cows are still running together, the mothers and the babies, because the folks who are raising this herd, they don't take the calves away from the mothers until they're about 6 months old. But they're being very, very careful to make sure that the rules of the Torah are upheld. They're not going to be tagging the animal or branding or marking her in any form. She's not going to be used for any activity, because all of those things, according to Torah law, would disqualify the heifer from being a candidate for the numbers 19 red heifer. So the plan is to watch her and take care of her, and the Temple Institute is very appreciative of these wonderful people that are really hoping that they'll be able to merit to see this red heifer used for the building of the third temple. And the heifer is not going to be receiving any growth hormones or any types of feed that might have growth hormones. Neither is her mother. Her mother's also not getting any steroids or hormones. She's being fed grass and hay. And everything is being done here in extreme sensitivity and respect to the requirements of the raising of the red heifer, according to the Torah of Israel, as described in Numbers 19 and expounded upon in the Jewish tradition. You know, every time a red heifer is sighted, we try to stay on top of the situation, we try to be informed. There have been a number of red heifers born in recent years that have become disqualified for one reason or another, the sprouting of white hairs. We're all excited about this one and watching with tense anticipation, since there is a tradition that all throughout history, there were 9 perfect red heifers that were used for the cleansing and the purification, and that the appearance of the 10th red heifer is associated with the advent of the Messianic era and the rebuilding of the temple, the third temple. And we look forward to the fulfillment of the verse in Ezekiel 36. Then I shall sprinkle pure waters upon you, and you shall be clean. From all your uncleanness and from all your idols will I cleanse you. I will also give you a new heart, and I will place within you a new spirit. And may it be God's will that we all merit soon to see the rebuilding of the third temple.